Okay, I love you all.
We love you.
Okay. Good evening, dear ladies. I would like to bless all of us, Bezat Hashem. May Hashem give us the zchut to greet Mashiach Tzidkenu b'mera b'yameinu, amen. We have the zchut to see and hear the Mevaser Eliyahu HaNavi, Eliyahu Tishbi, Eliyahu Gledi, b'mera avonu Mashiach David, Eliyahu Nevzechu l'tov. May we all have the zchut to go to the land of Israel on the wings of eagle. May we all have the zchut to have part in the land of Israel. And I bless all of us b'ktiva v'chatima tova Bezat Hashem. And may Hashem write and seal us, subscribe and seal us, Bezrat Hashem, in the book of life. Bezrat Hashem, shana tova mevorechet aleinu v'al kol am Yisrael. And may this shiur, Bezrat Hashem, that includes, this is the last shiur of the year here in the synagogue of the Georgian Jews, Bezrat Hashem, includes all of the shiurim that was before, and b'siyata d'ishmaya, may there will be plenty of shiurim this new year, Bezrat Hashem. And when we'll, Bezrat Hashem, may Hashem bring us so much happiness, because this coming year is Tafshin Ayin Chet, it's 5,778. And this is the initial of Tehe Shana Im Chupot. So this year, everybody is getting married. And may Hashem give us such a blessing that we can't even take off the dress and we'll go from wedding to wedding, Bezrat Hashem. Bebinyan Ade'ad.
על כל השיעורים, על כל הימים, מה שאת עברתי
איתם.
ברוך
השם, תודה רבה להשם.
שנזכה חופה שלך,
אמן.
אמן. אמן של הבן שלי. אמן. חתימה טובה.
אמן. אמן. And I have to say thank you to Madlena. Yes, כי was Madlena every... On every July, every Tammuz, we start a new year. Now we went into the ninth year, Ben Porat Yosef, that we have in the Shiurim every week in the Georgian Shul. So this is a yeshiva. It's not a regular thing. It's already a yeshiva because it's every week we meet. And we have a Foshot Chala, and we have celebrations. And now we went to the Tzadikim together. It's Baruch Hashem. It's a family. It's not a regular thing. We are family, Baruch Hashem. So I would like to bless her, Bezrat Hashem, that Hashem will give her to see Nachat. Madlena Malka Bat Simcha, and her husband David Ben Osnat, Bezrat Hashem. May they see Nachat from all Yotzei Chat Latzeim, Bezrat Hashem. May they have long life, Bezrat Hashem, with happiness, health, wealth, Bezrat Hashem. And may we all be zoche to see Mashiach Tzitzel Mimara B'Yameinu Amen and to greet him. And Bezrat Hashem, Barichut Yamim, Bebriut Netana, Velev Tov V'Sameach. And this is the time to say thank you. So I have to say thank you to Hashem for all my Talmidot. It's not muvan me'elav, it's not obvious. Hashem brought me like, I can't explain it. It's like Hashem loves me. You're so righteous, so good, be'emet. I have to say thank you to Hashem. If there's no Hasidim, there's no rabbi. So thank you, Hashem, for my Hasidot. Baruch Hashem. Bezrat Hashem, in a minute we'll say forgiveness. I would like to thank Hashem for all of my sisters, and among them to thank Yochevet Bat Dvorah, and my sister Sigalit Bat Yona. Baruch Hashem. Hashem, and I would like to thank Talia, Bezrat Hashem, Talia Bat Violet Segula, and each and every one of you. Each and every one of you, Bezrat Hashem, name by name, Baruch Hashem, including Adina, Baruch Hashem, and Shoshana, and Malka, and each one of you, Baruch Hashem. I would like to say thank you for being with us the whole year, for schlepping all of the year. For every time I call them, well, we have to go to this, we have to go, and Yecheva tells my sister, you see what she makes us do? If they don't want to do want, it doesn't matter. They have to schlep with me. Even Madlena schleps myself. Rotza or lo rotza. So I have to say thank you. Really, Hashem, thank you for the zchuyot, for the merit that Hashem gave us to be together. I bless you, Bezrat Hashem, that you will all be blessed in Klal Yisrael, mipi elyon, ba kol mi kol kol. With everything from Hashem, with all of the blessings from the Torah, Bezrat Hashem, that Hashem will shower you and Klal Yisrael with all of his blessings, Be'ezrat Hashem. And may we all be zoche to do tshuva, to repent, that Hashem's will be our will, b'siyata dishmaya, and we won't have any will except the will of Hashem. Amen. And all of the people that are converting to Judaism, that Hashem will give them the strength to finish it until the end, because it's a schut. Nachon, they're accepting upon themselves 620 commandments when they can only follow 7 commandments. So it's a big schut and a big responsibility to do this. So I bless them, Bezrat Hashem, that Hashem will give them the strength to do that, Bezrat Hashem. And may Hashem, Bezrat Hashem, that we will make Hashem happy, because Hashem loves us unconditionally. So may we make Hashem happy, Bezrat Hashem. Amen, Keni Ratzon. Amen, amen. Amen, amen. Amen, Bezrat Hashem. Amen, amen, Bezrat Hashem. Well, so dear ladies, I ask for your forgiveness. If chas, and the ones that watch the shiurim, chas v'shalom, anybody chas v'shalom felt uncomfortable or felt nifga or was offended or something, please forgive me. Say machulach, machulach, machulach. Now I will say to all of you, Bezrat Hashem, machulachen, machulachen, machulachen. And I love you with all of my heart, Baruch Hashem, and I love Hashem. So now, Baruch Hashem, אנחנו באים להתחיל בכל, all of the הלכות, המנהגים of the end of this year, בעזרת השם and Rosh Hashanah. When we have a lot, Baruch Hashem. First of all, look, this parasha, parashat Ki Tavoi, we usually read it, part of it, ממש silently. There are so many curses over there. Baruch Hashem, very frightening. It's frightening even to read it. Just by reading this, you should be afraid of Hashem. Just by reading this. So, B'siyata Dishmaya, our sages saw to it that Parashat Ki Tavo will be Parasha before Parashat Nitzavim and Vayelech, in order that we will read this before Rosh Hashanah. Why? Because Tichle Shana V'Klaloteha, that the year will end with all of its curses and all of its suffering, V'tachel Shana U'Virchoteha, and then you will come with all of its blessings, showering us and Klal Yisrael and the whole world with blessings. So I would like to bless all of you. I wrote it over here. L'shana ba tikatevu v'techatemu le'altar, that you will be subscribed and sealed now, Bezrat Hashem, l'chaim tovim v'leshalom, to good life and peace. If a person has peace, he has everything. Just know that if you have peace at home, you have everything. Everything comes because Hashem said that he puts his blessings in a place that has peace. Don't fight with your husbands, know your children, remember everything is a test from Hashem, don't fight with anyone. Don't wait for Yom HaKippurim to ask forgiveness. Even if you are right and somebody is not right, say I'm sorry, Mechila. Be a big person with a big heart, say Mechila. Bring something sweet and start the year that everybody will mochel, will be forgiving for everybody else. And you forgive everyone that wronged you. Everyone. Remember, it's only from Hashem. It's only the stick of Hashem. So forgive everyone. Tell Hashem, light candles for tzaddikim, put charity, and say to Hashem, Hashem, I forgive everyone that wronged me. Even if they did it on purpose or not on purpose, or I didn't understand them, it doesn't matter. I forgive everyone, because if you forgive, Hashem will forgive you in the big judgment day on Rosh Hashanah. Forgive everyone. It's nonsense anyway. We are only visitors. It's only, you know, somebody is coming to Latzik Lanu. How do you say Latzik Banglit? Bother us, only to bother us in order that we will do tshuva, not more than this. Because we're only visitors. We come, we say hello, and we go back to the true world. But this is a big world, because only here we can do all the good deeds and all of the commandments, and we only this is the world of action. So, livriut, emet. So let's continue, Bezrat Hashem. First of all, I would like us to start with the month of Elul. On the 24th of Elul is the Yahrzeit of the Chafetz Chaim. 24th of Elul, it's Livriut. It's on Shabbat. Shabbat is the 24th of Elul, and this is the Yahrzeit of the Chafetz Chaim. So when you light a candle to the Chafetz Chaim, please say that in the Zchut of the Chafetz Chaim, may Hashem forgive us for all of the slandering, Leshon Hara, everything that we said that not in the will of Hashem, in the zchut of the Chafetz Chaim. Ze mamash like showering ourselves from every word that we said that wasn't in place. So ask from Hashem and ask from Hashem that He will help us to fix this. Any word that we said in the zchut of the Chafetz Chaim, when you light the candle, I will send you a text, Bli Neder, for the Chafetz Chaim. You light the candle for the Chafetz Chaim before lighting the candles of Shabbat. Ki chaf hei ze yotze biyom...
Shabbat.
Chaf hei ze yom Shabbat or chaf dalid?
Chaf hei Shabbat.
Okay, so you light the candles on Friday. On Friday it's chaf dalid, so on Friday is the yortzet of the Chafetz Chaim. So besiata dishmaya, are you sure it's not chaf hei yom rishon?
Chaf hei is Shabbat, the 16th of...
Can? It's not Sunday? Regga, Shabbat, Chafei, Chafav, Chazayim. Chafav, Chazayim, Chafchet, Chafet. Okay, you're right, it's Shabbat. So dear ladies, Chaf Daled, it's Friday. Bezrat Hashem, you light a candle to Chafetz Chaim and you ask in His zchut that may Hashem take off all of your slandering, Lashon Hara, and give you the strength to control your mouth before you say something, to think before you take it out of your mouth, Bezrat Hashem. Chavdalit, Ken, Friday. Now,
Friday or Saturday?
No, Friday. Yocheved says it's on the calendar.
Chavdalit is Friday.
Okay.
So the
what, evening or?
So we can put on the candle Thursday night.
Ken, so Chaf Hei is Shabbat. Wait, and why is it so important? Because Chaf Hei is the first day of creation. I wrote it over here. Chaf Hei is on Shabbat. It's the first day of creation when Hashem said, Vehi Ol. That on the 25th of the month of Elul, Hashem started creating the world. It was the first day of creation. The sixth day of creation, Hashem created humanity, which is Rosh Hashanah. So why Rosh Hashanah is considered the big judgment day and all humanity is judged? Because on the sixth day when Hashem created humanity, at the first hour of the sixth day, it came into His mind to create humanity. The second hour, He asked the angels. The third hour, He took earth from all parts of the world. The fourth hour, He already gathered all of the earth, and then He made a dough out of it. In the fifth hour, He made a golem, and so on. And then when he put life inside the first human being, He told him not to eat from the tree of knowledge, good and bad. He gave him two commandments. One is to multiply, and one is not to eat from the tree of knowledge. At the next hour, he sinned. He ate from the tree of knowledge. At the hour after that, he was standing in front of Hashem to be judged. And the hour after that, he repented and Hashem found him not guilty. Hashem forgave him. So he told him from here on, every year on Rosh Hashanah, on the sixth day of creation, all humanity, all of your children are going to be judged. The first day of Rosh Hashanah, it's the Jewish people that are judged. Why? Because we are His firstborns. So the firstborns which have responsibility over the whole world, they are judged first. We are the first to be judged. And then all of the nations are judged. And after the nations, each one of them, each human being in the nation that is judged, after that, all of the countries are judged. All of the countries all over the world. And everything that he decided on Rosh Hashanah, because on Rosh Hashanah, three books are open. The book of life, the book of intermediate, and the book of death. So anybody that is judged on Rosh Hashanah is written in all of humanity, everyone, all and every human being is written either in the book of life, if they're righteous in the book of life, wicked in the book of death. The ones that the scale did not determine yet if they deserve life or death, they have 10 days of atonement between Rosh Hashanah and Yom HaKippurim, and on Yom HaKippurim it is sealed. It's sealed. The judgment is sealed. The notes are written. It's very important. The notes are written, dear ladies. So we have 10 days, and we don't know if we are righteous, wicked, or intermediate. We have to repent all the time. Every morning when we wake up, please Hashem, help us to do mitzvot, to do good deeds. Mamash, after you said, Modeh ani, yudin netilat yadayim, please Hashem, do that, that this day will be full with mitzvot and good deeds. If you ask Hashem, he sees to that, that you will do mitzvot and good deeds. So dear ladies, these are the 10 days of atonement in order to multiply the mitzvot and the good deeds. We'll speak about it, but I'm reminding you, the Monday after Rosh Hashanah in the shul, Bezrat Hashem, we are going to gather between 7 to 7:30 in order to do Afrashat Chala. So we'll have the mitzvot of Afrashat Chala and Sudat Amenim before Yom HaKippurim, before the judgment is sealed. So dear ladies, after Rosh Hashanah, Monday, 7 o'clock in the shul, we're going to have Afrashat Chala. We always do two big Afrashat Chala on the 10 days of atonement and after Pesach. After Pesach, Chalat Mafteach, the key Chala.
September 25th.
Yes, I think it's 7 o'clock to be here, Bezrat Hashem. It's September 25th. It's exactly after Rosh Hashanah, Monday after Rosh Hashanah. It's
25?
It's 8 Tishrei, but the English date? Okay, 5th of Tishrei, the 25th, Bezrat Hashem, of the month of September. Okay. So, dear ladies.
I just wanted to ask if Hashem, you said that Hashem forgave Adam, but he brought death.
Nachon, he forgave him.
He punished him.
No. He punished himself. Don't you remember I gave you shiurim? Hashem gave me the zchut to give you. Because he ate from the tree, he told him, if you'll eat, you'll bring death upon yourself. Why? Because you erase the three character traits. Okay, thank you. The three character traits, jealousy, lust, and honor, take a human being out of this world. So he brought it upon himself. But he gave him to live 930 years. It's a one day of Hashem is 1,000 years. It's written in Tehillim chapter 90. So he didn't kill him immediately. He gave him to live 930 years, which means he forgave him. He gave him a whole life to live. So dear ladies, Besiyata Dishmaya, I'm reminding you, Bezrat Hashem, another thing, this coming Shabbat is supposed to be Shabbat Mevarchim, Shabbat that we bless the first day of the month of Tishrei, the first month of the year. But it's not Shabbat Mevarchim. And why? In order to confuse Satan that he won't know when Rosh Hashanah is. When is the first day of the first month of the year. Why? Because then he comes and he prosecutes. And we don't want him to prosecute. So on this Shabbat, every Shabbat, Mevarchim, Shabbat that we bless the month, the rabbi in the shul is decrees when exactly is the first day, exactly the time, mamash. But this Shabbat, he won't do that. Because we don't know. Why? Because we don't know. We don't want Satan to know that. Furthermore, we still read the book of Tehillim. So please still read the whole book of Tehillim because it's more schuyot, more merit before Rosh Hashanah. So still read it, but we don't declare that when is exactly the first day of the month. And furthermore, why don't we do that? So Balatanya says that he heard this from his rabbi and he heard this from Baal Shem Tov Zchutot Hagen Eleinu. He says that because we do not declare the first day of the first month of the year on this coming Shabbat, Shabbat Mevarchim, Hashem himself blesses the year, the first day. And from this we can bless each month. Hashem himself blesses the first day of the first month of the year. And with this blessing, this power that Hashem gives, we bless all the 11 months of the year. And if it's a leap year, of all the 12 months of the year. That Hashem himself. Now I would like to remind you, on the 25th of Elul, I told you that Bezrat Hashem, this is the first day of creation. And I'm going to the book of Tfilah LeMoshe, Rabbi Chaim, Rabbi Mordechai Shara, Bizchuto Tegen Aleinu. And he says this. He says, Bezrat Hashem, Tikun Belimud Miyuchad Leshmira Vatzlacha Belel Chafei Be'elul V'yom Chafei Be'elul V'yimei Briat HaOlam. It's a special tikun, a fixing for the first day of creation. So he says, Katav Rabbeinu Yosef Chaim, the Ben Ish Chai, he wrote in his book, Lashon Chachamim, Be'yom Chafei Be'elul, on the 25th of Elul, Tizaher Bo Lekadsho Be'yoter. You should be very careful to sanctify this day. And this day is Shabbat. This year it's Shabbat, which means Friday night, it's already Shabbat. It starts Chafei Be'elul. וסמוך לבין השמשות של אל חפי, תעשה תבילה אחת להביא רוח רע. You deep your body in the mikveh 7 times. To go to the mikveh, it's especially for men. Now we, it's Friday night, as we can't go. But before Rosh Hashanah, and even women, before Rosh Hashanah, before Yom HaKippurim, before the high holidays, it's a big mitzvah to go to the mikveh. Even women that don't have their period anymore. Ma? Yes, you go in, you merge your body in the mikveh without a bracha. But it's so important. So I want you to know, on the 25th of the month of Elul, the men should go Friday, because it's Shabbat, so Friday, tell your husbands, and dip their body 7 times in the mikveh. You go Bezrat Hashem after that, on Sunday or Monday before Rosh Hashanah. And also before Yom HaKippurim, it's good. So if you didn't have time before Rosh Hashanah, go before Yom HaKippurim. Go to a mikveh just to dip your body before Yom HaKippurim without a blessing. I know that in Borough Park and every place that has Hasidim, even women, they allow women to go. The mikveh are open. Some mikvot are not open, but before Yom HaKippurim, in Kboro Park, but לא אצלנו, לא נגיד Flatbush and Zell, I don't think everything is open. You have to call and be sure that it's open and go and dip your body before. And dip it 7 times, like the men now need to dip. 1, 7 times. And why 7 times? The first dip that they need to dip is to take away the bad spirit from themselves. You know, all of this bad energy of the Yetzer Hara, of the evil inclination that tells us what to do against the will of Hashem. The second immersion is to take out anger. Anger from us. This we need, everybody needs. Everybody gets angry like this. We just need to remind ourselves not to be angry, to listen to Hashem. It's not easy. So, dear ladies, the second immersion is for the anger. And then 5 immersions is in order, ועוד 5 שבילות לקבל הארת 5 אור דחסד. 5 lights of chesed, of mercy, that were in creation, that Hashem said, וירא אלוקים את האור כי טוב. So these are the 5 lights, 5 immersions, parallel to the 5 lights of mercy. So 7 immersions. כי חפי בלולו היה יום ראשון דששת ימי בראשית שנברא באור החסד. Because Chafei, the 25th of Elul, was the first day of creation that the light of mercy was created. Ve'tizaher kol ota laila, which means Friday night this year, Friday night and Shabbat, mikas u'midvarim betelim, not to get angry and not to say nonsense, not to speak about nonsense. Ve'lo litanot, so we don't fast because you're not allowed to fast on the 25th of Elul. Ela, but you have to eat, which is perfect because it's Shabbat, so we'll make it. Ela tochal balayla uvayom lechem uvasar. You need to eat bread and meat. Ve'tevarech birkat hamazon bekavana, and bless birkat hamazon, the blessing of the food, with the intention. Ve'tochal kol mine metika, and sweet things. Thank you, Hashem, for allowing us to eat sweet things. So no diets. See that you have sweet things on Shabbat, Baruch Hashem, and enjoy them. Don't feel guilty that you're gaining weight. You don't gain weight. We have neshama etara on Shabbat, you know, an addition to the neshama, to the soul on Shabbat. So enjoy the sweet things. So v'tochal mine metika, v'tarbe bo tzedakah, and put a lot of tzedakah before Shabbat, okay? Because it's the first day of creation. ותדליק אתה או אשתך באותו הלילה חמש נרות. So before lighting the candles of Shabbat, you light five candles for the five lights of chesed, of mercy that were created on the first day of creation.
Is that before, after the lighting for Chafetz Chaim, or before?
Chafetz Chaim is on Friday. You can, Thursday night.
Oh,
yeah, so you can light on Friday during the day and Thursday night, but this is before Shabbat candles, okay? You light five candles.
Five candles, זה נוסף, נוסף.
לא, את קודם מדליקה חמש נרות, אז תהי לך.
אני נגיד, מדליקה חמש נרות, נגיד, כן. אז נוסף עוד.
עוד חמש נרות, אבל בנפרד, לא קשור לנרות של שבת. You light five candles separately from the candles of Shabbat.
So,
Yom Shishi, before you light the candles of Shabbat, you light five candles and you say, this is for the light of mercy, the five lights of mercy that came upon the world when Hashem said, Vayo, let there be light. And then he says, Vayara Elokim et haor ki tov, and Hashem saw that the light is good. So you light five candles. Keneged chamisha or de chesed sheneemar, Vayara Elokim et haor ki tov. So dear ladies and וכתוב ואם יזדמן אותו יום שמוציאים בו ספר תורה תעלה לספר תורה בציבור and if they take out a book of Torah which is Shabbat they take out a book of Torah so try to be the ones that have aliyah so have aliyah when they read from the book of Torah this is the first day of creation dear ladies don't get angry don't get angry be smile all the time even if you feel that somebody makes you angry because you know the evil inclination doesn't rest So remember, this is the first day of creation. I shouldn't get angry. I should be happy. I should eat. You have to eat at night and during the day, meat and bread. It's Shabbat, so we always eat fish, meat, bread. Be happy. Sweet things in order that you will have a sweet year and a good judgment on Rosh Hashanah. So you need to eat. Now don't feel any guilt feelings because... Rabbi Mordechai Sharabi and Abayin Nishchai tells us to eat sweet things. So don't feel guilty and have it with mamash pleasure. Baruch Hashem. שזה כנגד חמש אורות של חסד שנבראו ביום הראשון של הבריאה. Now, dear ladies, Another thing that I want to say over here, I wrote this so you will remember everything. It's Hallel. Rosh Hashanah is the only high holiday that is on the first day of the month. All of the high holidays is in the middle of the month when the moon is full. This is when the moon is only a dot. The moon is missing. We can't see the whole moon, but it's a dot. And why? Because in order to show us that even if we feel that we are so far from Hashem, after the dot, it becomes the next day, it is more full. And the next day, we can see more of the moon. And the next day, more, until we come to the middle of the month and everything is full. It's all round. Hashem tells us, even if you feel that you are far from me, I love you, I give you another day of life, repent and come and you'll become closer and closer to me. So Rosh Hashanah is when the moon is covered. And why the moon is covered? Because again, that Satan won't know exactly when is Rosh Hashanah. And that's why it's in chapter 81 in Tehillim, it says, Tik'u b'chodesh shofar, blow the shofar on the month of shofar, b'kesel le'yom chagenu, on the time that the moon is covered. And then it says, Ki chok li Yisrael u'mishpat l'Elokei Yaakov, which means because this is the day that it's a judgment to the children of Israel and the whole world and all humanity. So that's why these days between Rosh Hashanah and Yom HaKippurim are called Ben Kese le'Asor. Kese is Rosh Hashanah. It's when the moon, Kese, will shon kisui, the moon is covered. And there's only one small dot. We don't see the whole moon. And Asor is Yud, the 10th of the month of the Tishrei, which is Yom HaKippurim. Yom HaKippurim is in the 10th of the month of Tishrei. So the next question, if this is a high holiday, we say every high holiday, and Rosh Chodesh Bezrat Hashem, we say the Hallel. Why don't we say Hallel on Rosh Hashanah? On Rosh Hashanah, we do not say Hallel. It says in Masechet Rosh Hashanah that the angels came to Hashem and they told Hashem, why do the children of Israel don't say Hallel? Why don't they praise your name? You know, we have all of the chapters of Tehillim to praise the name of Hashem. And Hashem says, three books are open in front of me, the book of life, the book of death, and the book of intermediate, and you asking why the children of Israel are not saying Hallel? Out of the fear of the day of Rosh Hashanah. But still, we are happy on this day. Why? Because it's our Father that is judging us. It's like when a father and mother are looking at their children, always they judge them in mercy. So Bezrat Hashem, Hashem will judge us Bezrat Hashem with mercy because we are His children. And He knows that children don't always do what their father and mother say because they are only children. When the Bezrat Hashem becomes smarter and wiser, and when that subconscious comes into their conscience and they become knowledgeable of Hashem, Bezrat Hashem, they do exactly what Hashem wants. Mm-hmm. As Besiyata Dishmaya, this is another thing. Achshav Erev, please pay attention. At the eve of Rosh Hashanah, which is Wednesday, because Wednesday night is already Rosh Hashanah. Wednesday, we end the year by saying Nishmat Kol Chai. Please write it down. Please say it. Nishmat Kol Chai. Wednesday, the eve of Rosh Hashanah.
Before.
During the day? During the day. Erev Rosh Hashanah. During the day before Rosh Hashanah. It's the end. It's mamash. We al hagvul shel Rosh Hashanah. We say Nishmat Kol Chai. And then you say thank you to Hashem. You can dance at home, sing to Hashem. A mitzvah gedol aliyot besimcha. Toda rabba Hashem. On Wednesday, during the day. Dance to any time. Dance to Hashem and say thank you Hashem for all of the suffering that I had this year and all of the years before. Thank you Hashem for all of my children, my husband, my grandchildren, my great-grandchildren. Thank you Hashem for the food, for the roof, for my that I'm full with my body, that I can walk. Thank you for everything. You wake me up in the morning, everything. And I know Hashem that you're going to write me in the book of life. And I know Hashem that you're going to give me a wonderful year. Me and Klal Yisrael. That's what you need to say. Because Hashem says, and everything is written, if you are so happy with me for all of the suffering that you went through, and you're happy with all I gave you, I have to write you in the book of life. So please, it's a big segula before, on the eve of Rosh Hashanah, to say Nishmat Kol Chai and to mean it. And then say thank you to Hashem. And then, please, open Parashat Ki Tavoh, which the curses are in that parasha, and read at the beginning of that parasha, chapter 26, Perek Chavav, Psukim Aleph Ad Yud Aleph, verses 1 until 11. This is exactly all of the things that we say, Alavad Bikurim, that we say thank you to Hashem, that Bezrat Hashem brought us to the land of Israel, and this is the first fruits, Bezrat Hashem, that we give to Hashem. I would like to read you something about this. Ken, after Nishmat Kol Chai. And I would like to tell you, listen, Katuv Kacha, Arav Chaim Falaji says about this, in the name of Rabbi Yosef Mordoch, Misaloniki, it says this, Kol HaKoreh Parasha Zo, Parashat HaBikurim. Anybody that reads the Parasha of Bikurim, of bringing the first fruits to the Kohen, this is again chapter 26, verses 1 to 11. He who reads this, Kol HaKoreh Parasha Zo, HaKadosh Baruch Hu Ma'avir Karuz Barakia Vomer, Hashem brings, makes a decree in heaven, and he says, Gaviti Me'adam Ze Et Kol HaChovot. I took from this person all of his sins, and I forgive him, ומוחל על כל אבונותיו, and I forgive him for all of his sins. Listen again. You say נשמת כל חי, and you say thank you. At the eve of Rosh Hashanah, Wednesday, this year it's Wednesday. During the day, yeah, before Rosh Hashanah. It's the last day of the year. And then you say in between the things. You see, I know we have a lot of things to finish cooking and baking, but if we stop in the middle only for the sake of Hashem, it's such a big mitzvah, because Hashem says, yo, I see my daughter that she's so occupied, and the children and the grandchildren, you have to finish everything. He says, my daughter takes time, even though she's so occupied, finds the time just for me to say thank you, and then to read Parashat HaBikurim, because Parashat HaBikurim is like Maaser. So he's saying thank you to Hashem that you give him, that you have all the first fruits. Rabbi Chaim Falaji says, Beshem, Rabbi Mordoch Misaloniki, that a decree goes in heaven and says, I took from this person, I forgive him for his sins, Bezrat Hashem, but then, okay, tiskeru, but remember, you cannot do this and then think in your mind, well, I'm going to sin after that, and that's, no. You have to be in tshuva to tell Hashem, I will, besiata dishma, make your will my will, that, oh, I won't have any will except for your will, that I want to do tshuva, Bezrat Hashem. You have to remember, it's not that I'll say, okay, I'll read this and then my Hashem will forgive me and I will continue with all of my sins. Chas v'shalom. You think in your mind for tshuva. And this Be'ezrat Hashem will bring us into the new year, Be'ezrat Hashem, and that we will be written in the book of life, and I bless Klal Yisrael to be written Be'ezrat Hashem in the book of life. And all humanity that follows Hashem to be written in the book of life. יכולה לקבל קצת מים? פרשת כי תבוא. פרשת כי תבוא, פרק חף וב, פסוקים א' עד י' א'.
It's not in the beginning.
It's in the beginning. It's exactly the beginning of פרשת כי תבוא.
If you go to the shul, they're going to tell you this.
I'll show in the חומש בלי נדר בסוף השיעור. Okay. Let's continue. It's very important. I have a few things, and remind me, Oshana Rabba, that you won't go out before I tell you what to do, Blin Eder, on Oshana Rabba. Chaf Vav, Perek Chaf Vav, 26, זה בגימ... בסדר? פרקים א' עד י' א'. Now, ערב... תודה. ברוך אתה, אדוני, אלוהינו, מלך העולם, שהכל נהיה בדברו.
אמן.
אוח, תודה. תזכי למצוות. אוקיי, wait, כן. עוד מעט. בלי נדר. בנות, another thing. Every month, Hashem gives me the זכות to give you the name of Hashem for that month. So now I'm reminding you. For the month of Tishrei, it comes from the verse in Bereshit that says, ויראו אותה שרי פרעה. The ministers of פרעה saw her. שרה. So the end letters in each word is the name of Hashem for the month of Tishrei. It's the letter Vav, the letter Hey, which is Kuf. I write Kuf, but it's Hey. The letter Yud and the letter Hey. And then the name of Hashem of Repentance, it's the letter Yud, the letter Hey, the letter Aleph, and the letter Hey. Okay? This is the name of Hashem. You'll see Baruch Ata Hashem, Mekadesh Yisrael, V'Rashei Chodashim. So you'll see it in the middle of Musaf of Rosh Hashanah, Be'ezrat Hashem. Then you just concentrate on it. We have 2 days of Rosh Hashanah. Rosh Hashanah is 2 days, also in Israel. It's not the second day of exile, but both of them is 2 days. It's the essence of Rosh Hashanah. Ze Yom Ha'arichta. It's one long day. So, dear ladies, also in Israel, it's 2 days. Now I would like to continue at the eve of Rosh Hashanah on Wednesday. Shh. On Wednesday, Be'ezrat Hashem, don't forget, before that, you know, before Rosh Hashanah, I'm reminding you, check the tefillin, check the mezuzot. Go and do atarat nedarim to take off your vows and promises. You go in front of Beit Din, which means in every shul, in the morning, ask the rabbi, there's 3 talmidei chachamim, 3 sages, sit down, and you tell them that you want to take off your vows that you did the whole year, and you read from the book, and they answer you back, and they take off all of your vows. So please do it, atarat nedarim. Don't forget mikveh for men, and for women, dear ladies, don't forget everything that we do before Yom Tov. Nails, to cut the hair, tell your husbands, your children. And I would like to tell you also, there are some that do ta'anit on the eve of Rosh Hashanah until after Mincha, and then they eat something so they won't be in ta'anit before they go into their high holiday. It's a minhag. עכשיו אני רואה, הנה, עכשיו מגיעים. And don't forget because the holiday is Thursday, Friday, and then we have Shabbat. So we have to do Iruv Tavshilim on Wednesday. On Wednesday, before the holiday, we do Iruv Tavshilim. And you have it in the Siddur, what to bless for Iruv Tavshilim. You have it in the Siddur, and then you take lechem kebetza, you take bread, matzah, or challah. You take amount of like approximately 50 grams, and you put it in a plate, and you take tavshil. It can be an egg or a fish or something, like 30. It's all recorded, please. It's like 30 grams, you put it in one plate, and you bless. And because you blessed, you're allowed to cook on Friday for Shabbat. Because the high holiday, you're allowed to cook. So what do? You put a candle, like a candle of 7 days put over there, and you do havara, you transfer from one candle, light from light. You are not allowed to lavir.
Strike a match
or,
you know, kindle a fire.
Or start a fire. You're not allowed to kindle a fire, but you're allowed to so havara, to transfer from light to light, Bezrat Hashem. So don't forget before the chag to have a long light over there in order to do that. Another, this I said, okay, Erev Rosh Hashanah, the night of Rosh Hashanah, try to read the whole Tehillim. You have 2 days, okay? So try it, so even read if it's very hard for you, half of the Tehillim, and then the next night read the other half so you finish the whole Tehillim, one book. Except for the three chapters that we add, we add until Yom Kippurim, until the Ne'ilah, after the Ne'ilah Shel Yom Kippurim. So we try to read the whole book of Tehillim. The night of, you finish the meal, then sit down and write it as much as you can, and the next night also as much as you can, okay? Both days as much as you can. You're allowed to sleep. It says that you shouldn't sleep on Rosh Hashanah, but we can't. We have children. So you're allowed to sleep after Chatzot HaLaila, which means like 12 something, you're allowed to sleep. But before that, read Tehillim. Try to read Tehillim, the whole book. If you can, both days, the whole book, it's good. If you can't, half of it and then half of it the next day. The men, Chatzot HaLaila.
Group at 12 o'clock at night?
You can mutar acharei chatzot halayla lishon. If you can't hold yourself, you're allowed to. Don't sleep before chatzot halayla, sleep after chatzot halayla. You understand? After 12, approximately 12:10, then you can sleep. Try not to sleep before that. So before that, read Tehillim. Okay? Read Tehillim before that. The men read Masechet Rosh Hashanah. After the meal and after everything, they should sit down and study Masechet Rosh Hashanah, Be'ezrat Hashem.
What about sleeping during the day, the 2 days?
So, Rosh Hashanah lo yashnim. That's why I'm telling you, sleep after the, acher chatzot ha-laila, okay? Chatzot
at night.
Ken.
But during the day.
During the day, Be'ezrat Hashem, Hashem will help you. Read Tehillim. So you mnamnem and then open. And then again, read Tehillim. I call you ever. So it's not considered the. Nachon, she lo yishnu. But the women, she doesn't ask. She asked about the women. Women. Ken. Rak ha-tfila. Rak ha-tfila lokachat 2-3 ba-tzoraim. Okay, dear ladies, let's continue. And the men read Masechet Rosh Hashanah. Bederech Lagam, it's good to read Masechet Beitza, because Masechet Beitza includes all of the Jewish laws about high holidays. Rad Bezrat Hashem. Achshav, dear ladies, from now on until Rosh Hashanah, which is also considered before, aval kol hayom, the whole day, la'asok, to be engaged with Torah, tell your husbands, your sons, Torah, be'mitzvot, good deeds, v'betshuva, and repentance all the time. Hashem, please forgive us for everything that we did, because you remember, notnim lebetula 12 chodashim, we give Virgo 12 months, which means Virgo is the constellation of the month of Elul, and it gets all of the 12 months inside it. So we ask forgiveness from Hashem. Plenty of tzedakah. The best tzedakah is when a person doesn't know who gave the tzedakah. So give a gabay or give somebody that you know that knows poor people or people that need help, And they will give, oh, I have an envelope again for the people in Israel that need. Remind me to give it to you at the end. Please, it's over here. I forgot to give it to you. Now let's continue. And וכל שכן בין אדם לחברו לא ימתין עד יום הכיפורים, which means furthermore that if we have sins between us and other people, or you know, bad feelings or anger, please say, go and say, please forgive mechila. You need to be a big person, a bigger person, even if you know that you're right. Just לא חשוב. And if the person doesn't forgive you, find a messenger that he hears to him. You need, by the Rambam, it says 3 times, the Shulchan Aruch. You send a messenger to ask for forgiveness. If he didn't forgive you, it's his sin already. It's not yours. But you need to mean it, that you really want the forgiveness. And tell Hashem that you are forgiving everyone. Tell Hashem, I forgive everybody, anybody that wronged me on purpose and not on purpose, or I was hurt from by somebody without even understanding if he really wanted to hurt me or not. So Bezrat Hashem, I forgive everybody. And you say, machul lahem, machul lahem, machul lahem. So you don't have any cheshbon, any account with anybody, Bezrat Hashem. You come into Rosh Hashanah and you are clean. Let's continue. The last prayer of the day, of the year, Be'etzem. The last prayer of the year is Mincha. So try to say Mincha. Even if you didn't have time, just say Shema Yisrael in the morning if you didn't have time. But Mincha, try to make time, keep, because Mincha is the last prayer of the year. Mamash. Ken, betach, Mincha, kol Mincha. כל המנחה, you say פתאום הקטורת, you say אשרי, and then you say 18. And then בסייעתא דשמיא, you say בידוי, and then עלינו לשבח. All of the מנחה, you say all of the מנחה, and be concentrating. It doesn't take a long time, but concentrate, because this is the last prayer of the year. And then בעזרת השם, בנות יקרות, we come to הדלקת נרות, and reminding you, הדלקת נרות, when we light the candles and we bless for יום טוב, part of the Ashkenazi women say also, "Shechianu v'kimanu v'gianu l'zman hazeh ba'adlakat nerot," when they light the candles. Usually, the Sephardic women do not say that when they light the candles. They yotze with their husbands when they come for the kiddush, and he says, "Shechianu v'kimanu v'gianu l'zman hazeh." When he says, we answer amen, and then we are yotze with him. But if somebody did on adlakat nerot, he shouldn't answer amen on that, on the blessing when a husband says. Now let's continue. Don't forget that from Rosh Hashanah until Yom HaKippurim, during the davening of Shmona Esra, there's additions. Okay? Additions to each tefillah. You see it. It's written there. And I would like just to remind you that if we forgot to say the additions, we don't have to go back to the beginning of tefillah Shmona Esra except for one addition. HaMelech HaKadosh. If we didn't say HaMelech HaKadosh, then we have to go, the king, the holy king, if we didn't say that, we have to go to the beginning of Tfilat Shmona Esre. But there's additions, look at it, I won't go into it now, but there's additions to the prayers. Another thing, Birkat HaMazon, don't forget on Rosh Hashanah, Ya'ale Ve'yavo, also on Rosh Hashanah, but you read from the Machzor, so you have it big lines, Ya'ale Ve'yavo. And don't forget also, you mentioned Arachman, Yom HaZikaron, Bezrat Hashem, all of this in Birkat HaMazon. Rosh Hashanah, I told you to read the whole book of Tehillim, if it's hard for you every night, so at least read half of it and half of it the next night. Or you have plenty of people, if you have plenty of people at home, just divide the Tehillim between everybody and read it together. Don't forget, we start after Rosh Hashanah until Yom HaKippurim Avinu Malkeinu, including Shabbat. Don't forget Shabbat, Aseret Yemei Teshuvah. We say Avinu Malkeinu after Tfilat Shmona Esre. Now, I would like to remind you on Rosh Hashanah what we read from the Torah, Bezrat Hashem. Everything is connected to Sarah, Rachel, and Chana. because all of these three women, Sarah, Rachel, and Hannah, got pregnant on Rosh Hashanah, on the first day of the year. So everything is connected to them. We read in the first day how Hashem sends messengers, angels, to tell Avraham Avinu and Sarai Menu that she's going to be pregnant with a son, and the son's name will be Yitzchak. And then we read Taftara from Filat Chana, from the book of Shmuel the prophet, because Chana was also, איך אומרים נפקדה באנגלית? נכנסה להיריון.
Conceived.
So she was conceived also on Rosh Hashanah. The second day we read Akedat Yitzchak, when Avraham Avinu puts Yitzchak on the altar, and then the Haftarah will be Tfilat Rachel from the book of Yirmiyahu, the prophet Yirmiyahu. Rachel mevakal banea. Rachel is praying and crying for her children, Bezrat Hashem. Then I would like to remind you, אנחנו מגיעים לתקיעת שופר. תקיעת שופר, the blowing on shofar, on the last day of this year, which means on Wednesday, we do not blow the shofar after shacharit, because in order to distinguish between blowing the shofar, that is a minhag, that is a custom, between and blowing the shofar as a commandment from Hashem, because on Rosh Hashanah it's a commandment. We blow the shofar 100 times. It's before Musaf, in the middle of Musaf, and at the end of Musaf. 100 times we blow shofar. Why do we blow shofar? Because shofar, dear ladies, is the letters of Shapru. Ma'asechem. When we blow the shofar, Bezrat Hashem, you see it's the same letters. It means be better, make your deeds better. Shapru, make it better. It's the same letters of shofar. Why do we blow the shofar? Because on Rosh Hashanah we make Hashem king. HaMelech HaKadosh, HaMelech HaMishpat. He is the king of judgment. We make him a king. So when people make a person a king, they blow the trumpets. So we blow the shofar in order that we announce that Hashem is the king of kings. And then we blow to the shofar to remind Hashem for the merit of our forefathers, Avraham and Yitzchak. That Yitzchak, you remember, Avraham took the ayil, the deer that he found. Instead of slaughtering his son, he took the ayil, the deer, and he slaughtered, yes, ram. He took the ram and he slaughtered him. So we remind one of the karnaim, you remember of it? It's also for Achrit Hayamim, one of the horns. So dear ladies, תראו איך השם loves me, ברוך השם. So dear ladies, we blow the shofar to remind the merit of Yitzchak and Abraham to Hashem, so he forgive us in the merit of our forefathers. Then we blow the shofar also because it reminds Hashem the covenant that he made with the children of Israel, the treaty on Ma'amad Har Sinai, on the mountain of Sinai, because you remember once we received the Torah, והשופר הולך וגובר, they were blowing the shofar and it will became louder and louder and louder. And to remind Hashem that B'siyata Dishmaya, we are waiting to hear the shofar when Mashiach, when Messiah is here, Mashiach is here. So this is the shofar. Now let's continue. בתפילת מוסף, בתמילת מוסף, we say ונתנה תוקף. Oh, it's here. I didn't find. I would like to tell you who wrote ונתנה תוקף בתפילת מוסף on Rosh Hashanah. It's Rabbi Amnon Mimagenza. Rabbi Amnon Mimagenza was a big rabbi, a very big scholar in Torah, and he was very rich in Spain. And at that time, before Rosh Hashanah, in the month of Elul, the Hagmon, the bishop, came to him and he told him that he wants him to convert and to be Christian. And he told him, let me think about it 3 days. After 3 days, the bishop was waiting for him and he didn't come. And he sent soldiers to take him. So they brought him in front of him and he told him, why didn't you come? He says, I beg of you, please, cut my tongue, that dare to tell you that I will think about it for 3 days. The bishop said, why? The tongue was excellent to tell me this. Instead, he cut his legs and his fingers, Shalom Eda. And from there came people and took him mamash on Rosh Hashanah to daven, and this is what he wrote. And we say that in Mosaf of Rosh Hashanah. Ba-machzor, dear ladies. You remember that it's not called a sidur, it's called a machzor. So this is what it says. And he asked that they will pick him up, that he can say this. So it's written, Unetana tokef kedushat hayom, that we will all feel the holiness of this day. Ki nora ve'ayom, this is a very frightening day. Uvotin ase malchutcha, that your kingdom is shown. Ve'ikon b'chesed kisecha, and your throne is shown. Ve'teshev alav be'emet, and you are sitting on the throne. And I want to remind you, when we blow the shofar, Hashem moves from the chair of judgment to the chair of mercy. That's why you read chapter 47, Mem Zayin, 7 times, to remind Hashem to move from the chair of judgment to the chair of mercy. You see, before Tkiyat HaShofar, before blowing the shofar, we read chapter 47 7 times. So, dear ladies, it's written like this: Emet ki ata hu dayan u'mochiach ve'odeh va'ed. It's true that you are the big judge, and you are the one that tells us what to do. And you know everything. וכותב וחותם וסופר ומונה ותזכור כל הנשכחות. And you write and you count and you seal and you remember everything. All of the good deeds that we don't remember and all of the things that is we didn't do in your will. You remember every word that we took out of our mouth. ותפתח את ספר הזיכרונות ומאליו יקרן. You open the book of zichronot, of memories, and everything is read from there, because each person that comes, his book is open. You're standing in front of the judge and your book is open and all of the good deeds that you did are read from this, and all of the things that wasn't in the will of Hashem is also read. וחותם יד כל אדם בו, and everything is sealed. ובשופר גדול יתקע וכל דממה דק ישמע. And there's a blow of shofar and there is silence, because even the angels are afraid from the judgment day. ומלאכים יחפזון וחילו רעדה יואחזון. And the angels are running and they all are filled with the shivering fear. ויאמרו הנה יום הדין לפקוד על צבא מרום בדין. And this is the judgment day, that not only Hashem judges humanity over here, but also he judges the angels and everybody upstairs in heaven. כי לא יזעקו בעיניך בדין. And who can stand and judge in front of Hashem and be right? Nobody, there's nobody, even the most righteous person. King Solomon says, ki en adam she'aseh tov, en tzadik she'aseh tov ba'aretz ve'lo yechta. There's no righteous person who will do good in this earth and won't do a sin. And he says, v'chol baye olam ya'avrun lefanecha kivnei maron. And all humanity, person by person, go in front of you like a sheep. You know when there's a herd of sheep and then they have to go in, one by one goes in. So one by one stands in front of Hashem, all humanity, everybody. כבקרת רועה דרור, just like a shepherd, מעביר צונו תחת שבטו, and each sheep goes one by one. וכן תעביר ותספור ותפקוד נפש כל חי, and each one is judged. וחתכתוך קצבה לכל בריאה, and the parnasa is determined. On Rosh Hashanah it's written exactly the income that each person will have. ותכתוב את גזר דינם, and the judgment is written. בראש השנה יכתבון, on Rosh Hashanah they will be written, וביום צור כיפור יחתמון, and on יום כיפור we are sealed, כמה יעברון וכמה יבראון, how many will pass, and how many will be born in this world, מי יחיה ומי ימות לו, and who will live and who will die, everything you see during the years from Hashem, a person dies, a baby comes to the world, weddings, everything is from Hashem. Dear ladies, ומי בקיצור, who will die on the time that was already written for him, ומי לא בקיצור, or who will die earlier because of his sins, מי במים, who will die by water, who will die by fire, who will die by sword, who will die by animal, who will die by hunger, who will die by thirst, who will die by rash, earthquake, who will die by plague, who will die by suffocation, who will die by stoning, מי ינוח ומי ינוח, מי ישקוט ומי יתערף, everything, who will become crazy, not crazy, everything is decided. מי ישלב ומי יתייסר, what kind of suffering, everything is written. מי יעני, מי יעשיר, who will become rich, who will become poor, מי ישפיל, מי ירום, who Hashem is going to pick up and make him big, and who will Hashem take him from his bigness and take him down, he says, But he says, "Ut shuva, ut tfila, ut tzedakah, ma'avirin et ro'a gzera." That shuva, repentance, and praying, and davening, and giving charity will help us, bezrat Hashem, to get away from the judgment, that Hashem will forgive us. Ki b'shimcha ken tilatcha. קשה לכעוס ונוח לרצות, because you are you're not a God that gets angry so quickly, and you're just waiting for התשובה, and then you forgive us, בעזרת השם. כי לא תחפוץ במות המת, because you don't want the sinner to die. כי אם בשובו מדרכה וחיה, you just want him to repent. ועד יום מותו תחכה לו, and you're waiting for him, השם, until the last day that he lives. אם ישוב מיד תקבלו, and if he asks for forgiveness, immediately you accept him. So dear ladies, this is Unetana Tokef, and it says, once he finished to say that, dear ladies, at that moment he passed away. At the moment he read everything that he wrote, he passed away at that moment. So this is Rabbi Amnon Migamantza, if I'm saying right the name of the place, B'siyata Nishma Zchutot Hagen Aleinu. Then I'm reminding you of the first day of Rosh Hashanah, which means Thursday, after Mincha, there's Tashlich. V'tashlich b'mtzulot yam kol chatotam. Men usually go to a place where a river is livriut, and then they take out their pockets in order to put to like the 13 attributes of Hashem that he gave to Micha the prophet. Do tashlich. One of the attributes is v'tashlich b'mtzulot yam kol chatotam, that you will throw into the ocean, in the depths of the ocean, all of their sins. So this is tashlich. If you go from the synagogue, men and women, please let the men go first and you go behind. Don't speak with them. Because once they're speaking with the men, and it's not tashlich anymore. So either women usually, they don't have to go. So let the men do what they need to do. כמו שצריך. So after that, I'm reminding you on Sunday, it's Tzom Gdalia. Because it's supposed to be on Shabbat, but there's no fast on Shabbat, so Sunday will be Ta'anit Gdaliah, Tzom Gimel B'Tishrei, the third of Tishrei. I would like to say another thing, Hoshana Rabbah. I am telling you, please write it, because we'll see B'Aseret Yemei Teshuva, but I want you to write it now. It's a big sgula on Hoshana Rabbah. You remember Hoshana Rabbah, the seventh day of Sukkot. This is the day that the Ushpizin, the guest in our sukkah, is David HaMelech, King David. So on this day, how do we repent to Hashem? Only by praying. Davening, saying Tehillim, praying of that. We take five Arava, which Arava is like the mouth, and we say Chabit, Chabit, Vela Barich. We say that we give a tap on the floor, Vela barich, without a blessing. Why? Only for the mouth. Only for the sins of the mouth. And in the zchut, in the merit of David HaMelech, we ask from Hashem to forgive us. Why? Because on Shmini Atzeret is the day that the angels go out with all of the notes that were written on Rosh Hashanah, sealed on Yom HaKippurim. Until Hoshana Rabbah, we can still, Hashem gives us at the time that we can still repent, and they will tear on Hoshana Rabbah that notes and write a new note. But on Shmini Atzeret, it's too late. Shmini Atzeret, the angels go for each human being all over the world. And everything you see that happens to you, dear ladies, is everything that was already written on Rosh Hashanah and sealed on Yom HaKippurim. So in order that we don't know what was written, and in order that only good things will be written, on Hoshana Rabbah there's another segula. Except for Tehillim, there's another segula to read on Hoshana Rabbah 7 times Aleinu Leshabeach, only the first part. We read it from the beginning till the end, and then again from the end to the beginning. Only the first part, Lo Al Ken. We don't go to La Al Ken. Only the first part, Aleinu Leshabeach. From the beginning to Aleinu Leshabeach in the Siddur. It's the last, Shacharit, go to the last thing that we say on Shacharit. It's Aleinu Leshabeach, that Yoshua, the Navi, Yoshua that continued Moshe Rabbeinu, he's the one that wrote it, Aleinu Leshabeach. The first part, dear ladies, we start from the beginning till the end, then we read from the end to the beginning, the end, mamash, like this, to the beginning. And then we say the 42 names of Hashem, Anna Bekoach. And we end with Baruch Shem Kvod. So we say the 42 names, and then for the first time that we say Anna Bekoach. Then we read it again. You see, this is a set of one time. Then we read it again, and then we say Kra Satan. We say Kabel Rinatabecha Sagvenu Tarenu Nora. For each one after saying that 7 times. I will show you Bli Neder after the end of the lesson.
Back,
and then we say Anna Bekoach. You say all of it, and then you say 3 times the first. Then you say it again, front and back, and then you say all of them, all the 42 names, and then you say 3 times for the second time, Kabel Rinatamecha Sagvenuta. Then we go to the 3rd time, 7 times. Okay? This is a segula for Hoshana Rabbah. Now, dear ladies, we come to the... Hoshana Rabbah. It's the seventh day, during the day, not night. But night is already Shmini Atzeret and Simchat Torah. Dear ladies, it's Hoshana Rabbah is the 7th day of Sukkot. Now, we didn't speak about Ma'achalei Bracha. On Rosh Hashanah, we eat only sweet things. We don't eat spicy things. We don't, sour things because we want. We make a sign to Hashem, Simana de Milta, that Hashem will write us in the Book of Life, and we'll have such a sweet year, Bezrat Hashem. As Klal Yisrael and Bezrat Hashem, all of the righteous people in humanity, and all the ones that are not righteous, Bezrat Hashem, Hashem knows how to deal with them. Bezrat Hashem, all humanity will do tshuva, we repent. So, dear ladies, I want to give you these, and we're going to go through this. Okay, give me the rest that תחלקו לכם שם, תעביר אחורה. Even if you use, make it sweet after that. Not you don't want sour things.
Thank you.
כן.
בזמן התפיעת שופר, יש בקשות מיוחדות או אפשר לבקש מה שאנחנו רוצים?
Dear ladies, when...
תסביר ככה,
okay. When the shofar is blown, why do we blow the shofar? So we'll repent. So when the shofar is blown, ask from Hashem in your mind that Bezrat Hashem, He will accept our tshuva and the tshuva of Klal Yisrael. Ask for Mashiach and the end of suffering. And only good things for Klal Yisrael, because there's not enough time to ask. Only this, Mashiach, Eliyahu Navi Zachur Latov, and Zman Lepratim, you don't have time, but ask for repentance, that Hashem will accept all of our repentance. For us and Klaus, everybody has one. Bezrat Hashem, you have one in front of you.
Thank you.
Yes, betach. Efo yes od? Oh, yes la. כאן אין לכם? אוקיי. כמה צריכה? אז יש פה. תעבירו לה. Is there a leftover? Linor, you have leftover there? Okay. Everybody has one? Okay. Let's go through the... Oh. There are 2 things. How to do the blessings. יש שני מנהגים. The first מנהג is להרבות בברכות. Like the Moroccans do during the Kiddush of Shabbat, of Friday night. So what is the minhag? Is first Kiddush over the wine, And then before we do Netilat Yadayim and Amotzi, you start blessing. You take the Tamar. Why the Tamar? Because you remember on the table, there's Abrachot. We have pomegranate. We have Tamar. These are the fruits of the land of Israel. Tamar is a date. Tamar is date, okay? We have pomegranate and date. And if you have pomegranate and date, the date is the one that you bless before the pomegranate. So you bless over the etz, over the tamar. You say the hiratzon, and then you think that all of the blessing for the etz is for all of the etz that you have on the table. Okay? Then, rega. I'll give you the two things, and b'siyata dishmei, Hashem will help me to answer you before all. Just pay attention. So this is one of the minagim. Then we take adama, like a carrot or something that is not mevushal, that is not cooked, and we bless adama, and all the adama is yotze with this, okay? Then we take a keves, and we say shehakol, and everything on the table, shehakol yotze with this. Then we do netilat yadayim and amotzi. This is one minhag, one custom. The other custom that Rav Ovadia Yosef says, that you do the kiddush over the wine, you do the motzi, you bless over the bread, you eat like 30 grams kezait from the bread, and then you do a etz over the tamar, and then you say all of the hiratzon for each one. Adama you don't do, unless you have adama that is not cooked, and the keves you don't do. You don't say shakol because it's cooked, it's part of the meal. If it's part of the meal, you can't bless over it. It's part of the meal. But you bless the etz. If you don't bless over the other, the only things you do over the others is the yehiratzon. So look please at the paper. We have this, yehiratzon, okay? May it will be besiata dishmei, ratzon mifanecha Hashem, in front of you Hashem. We look at the pomegranate. We ask Hashem that this is a sign that pomegranate has a lot of seeds, shirbu zchuyoteinu kerimon, that our merit will be so plenty like the seeds, the number of seeds of the pomegranate. Then we'll look at the silka, the beet. You see the silka over here on the right side? The silka we ask from Hashem, Yiratzon, Shistalku, Oyvenu, Umalshinenu, that all of our enemies will go away, Bezrat Hashem, because silka, Milshon, Lesalek. It's this, it's the beet.
It's beets.
You see here, I'll show you over here. Then we come, you see over here, the sheep, it's either head of sheep or head of fish. Okay, it's very frightening to see the sheep with the eyes. Also the fish, it's not so... Well, Baruch Hashem. And see, we say, Yiratzon, that we will be head and not tail. Head and not tail. And not, why head? Besiata dishmaya, head and not tail. Head means lasot... Huh?
To lead.
Can, exact. Not only to lead. Retzon avinu shebashamayim. You see? Head means lasot... Retzon avinu shebashamayim. To do the will of Hashem. The initials are Rosh. You see? Head. Rosh. That Hashem will help us to do His will. So, this is Rosh. That we will do His will. Once we do His will, we are the leaders. That's why Hashem chose us as Jewish people to be the firstborn, to lead the nations. So, la'asot ratzon avinu shebashamayim. And furthermore, if when you take a sheep, it's to remind Hashem of Akedat Yitzchak, that the merit of Yitzchak Avinu. Then we go over here to kartei. It's leek, green leek. You see over here this kartei? Kartei milshon likrot, to eliminate. So we say, yiratzon shikartu sonenu, that Hashem will eliminate all of the people that hate the children of Israel. Be'ezrat Hashem. Then we go to the fish. You see the fish over here? Okay? We ask from Hashem fish. Shenifre venirbe kedagim, that we will multiply like fish. That no evil eye controls them because they're under the water. Nobody sees them. So eye doesn't control them. And they're in the water. The water is considered Torah. Hokotz ha-melech ulamayim, that we will be also swimming in the Torah. Dear ladies, so b'siyata dishma, be'ezrat Hashem. Now let's go to Kara. You see over here, this is איך קוראים לזה באנגלית? Squash, like squash over here. Kara. So dear ladies, we ask from Hashem that Kara milshon dikroa, that Hashem will tear the bad judgment, the not so good judgment, that we will hear atzon, that we'll have only good judgment, and only our merit will be in front of Hashem. Then we go to the carrot. The carrot is, dear ladies, שדיקרוא רק גרוא גזר דיננו ויקרא לפניך זכויותינו, that you will eliminate all of our sins, בעזרת השם, and only our merit will be in front of you. Also carrot in Yiddish, איך אומרים?
Mayan.
Mayan. Yes. So, and furthermore, that we will multiply in our zchuyot. Okay? Lat, lat. Now, rubia. Black eyed peas, rubia. Rubia, you see over here? Rubia, this is rubia. Black eyed pea. We ask from shirbu zchuyotenu, like all of the seeds inside of it, that may Hashem bring us a lot of zchuyot, a lot of good deeds. Then we have the apple. You see, tapuach bidvash, apple in honey, dear ladies. We ask that Hashem will renew on us a sweet year, a beautiful year, a year of kindness, a year of happiness, peace. So we dip the apple in honey. We dip, instead, we take the bread, and instead of, when we say a motzi, instead of putting in salt, we dip the bread in honey. Dear ladies, and there's a custom of Chabad the whole month of Tishrei to dip the bread in honey instead of salt. So why? In order to remind Hashem that we will be a sweet year. Then we have date. You see the date? So date, shi'itamu sonenu v'ayvenu, that the date is that b'siyata d'ishmaya, that all of our enemies and will Bezrat Hashem be eliminated and there won't be any, but Bezrat Hashem that there will be peace upon us, Klal Israel, and the whole world. Dear ladies, I would like to bless all of you, Bezrat Hashem, Beshana Tova Vemetuka, Bezrat Hashem, Ktiva Vechatima Tova Besiyata Dishma. I would like to tell you, Besiyata Dishma, this is the last lesson of the year, and Bezrat Hashem, the next year, plenty of lessons, Bezrat Hashem. Plenty of Torah, Bezrat Hashem. Besiyata Dishma. I would like to bless all of us. Shitgele Mashiach, Tzitkenu Bimara Bimeinu, Amen. Shegeh Ama Besar Eliyahu Nevi Zechur Latov, Leolam Yipared Adam Mechavaro Bidvar Halacha, Yachid Verabim Halacha Kerabim. Bezrat Hashem.